Hello guys, this is Sir Chakku here with yet another video. This one would be a PvP battle between me, Sir Chakku from Fat Squad Clan, against a rank 16 resistance player named Mad Crusader from Clan Red Wolf. So it will be a 23 minute long battle, so let's jump into it and see what happens. Okay, the map of choice would be the Abandoned Oasis, so a resistance map, I must say. Okay, so I'll be at the top while my opponent will be at the bottom side. So okay, barracks at the far edges of my base. Okay, switching to infantry, blue infantry training boost, as I don't have gold or red boost. So yeah, switching to red boost. Actually I was planning to make infantry attack boost, but I'd accidentally switched to red scouting boost. Okay, collecting containers, nice and easy. Okay, spotted one, I will collect one here as well. Okay, that rifleman got guild. Also upgrading my HQ to level 2. Okay, collecting this one container too. Okay, also scouted his base. He's also going for HQ level 2, same as me. Barracks as well, some supply centers too. That's nice. Meanwhile, I saw there are many riflemen over here, so I started producing some assaults. I'll be producing assaults now quickly. So I thought that he will be rushing me with riflemen at the start, but it was a semi rush, not an all out rush. Okay, semi rush. Oh, this is always very dangerous. Okay, coyote and many riflemen are there. My assaults are not well upgraded, but still they are all I have got at the moment. Also producing hammer. Those annoying riflemen and coyote managed to destroy my manpower plant, but I will use reconstruction boost. So it was kind of free for me. I had to use blue reconstruction boost to get that power plant back while he lost many of his units like riflemen and coyotes. So yeah, it didn't do much damage to me. Okay, I'll be upgrading to HQ3 any moment now. Okay, me and my producing hammer as well, so that in case his coyotes ever show up again, I will have a hammer to deal with it. Okay, another power plant. So as you see, during the start of the battle, I call this map a resistance map. You see, there is a very reason behind it why I consider it a resistance map. You see, in this map there are several, it is an open map with no choke points or anything. So in this map you can attack from several sides. You can attack from here, and from here. So it is an open map, no choke points, nothing. Camping is next to impossible on this map. So in this map, I believe speed and mobility will overcome brute strength anytime. So you can see, whenever I play resistance, I always use this strategy: go mass JCP, attack him on attack my opponent on multiple sides. Like if I attack him from here, the Zeus will come over here, and meanwhile I switch and attack from here. It will take a lot of time for his use to reach, move from here to here. Meanwhile, I can do any amount of damage and then retreat. So yeah, in the crux of the what I'm saying is that on this map, speed and mobility is more important than brute force. So taking that into consideration, I'll be going for hammers on this map. So I have HU3, so I'll be producing hammers from 3 vehicle factories. Though my hammers are not maxed out, at rank 16 the speed of hammer has to be 60, but the speed of my hammer is just 54. It's not maxed out, but I have to work with it. Yeah, I'm upgrading my hammer as we speak. They are very important comfort unit. So yeah, I'll be producing hammers, mostly mass hammers, and switch to another unit as the game goes on. Okay, producing hammer nice and fast. Me spreading out my rifleman so that I'll get notified when in case he ever decides to attack me. Setting up rifleman at every point through which he can attack. Also going for Zeus for me. Also going for Zeus wouldn't have been a wise choice for me as well, as he too could attack from multiple sides, like here. Since there are no choke points on this map, it would have been really hard for me to operate with slow Zeus. So I chose speed over brute force. That's why I'm going for hammers. Okay, fastening things up, producing hammers, nice and easy. Okay, I'll be moving out with my hammers now. Okay, Those are a lot of riflemen. I think he already knew that I was producing hammer, so he started spamming riflemen. I don't know. You see, I'm using, as I said, in this map, speed will always overcome brute force. So you see, instead of vehicle attack boost, I'm using vehicle scouting boost to increase the speed of my hammers, so that they don't get hit by these riflemen smoke grenades. Those smoke grenades will do the most damage onto my hammers. So in order to make sure that my hammers don't get hit by these smoke grenades, I'm using vehicle scouting boost. So I recommend, whenever you use hammers, I recommend you to use vehicle scouting boost instead of vehicle attack boost. So if you do so, your hammers will have enough speed to move away from riflemen, or if he has grenadiers, you can simply, you won't get hit by the grenade. So yeah, it's a better way than vehicle attack boost. Okay, fasting things up, I have a lot of hammers now as I speak. Okay, the whole screen is covered with hammers now. The advantage is there that they take only 2 command points, so taking full advantage of it, I'll be taking full advantage. Okay, so he was waiting for me at the bridge, at the entrance of the bridge, but yeah, my hammers are too many, so they will overcome his riflemen. So yeah, speeding things up. Okay, killing those riflemen by at the same time kiting my, he has some jaguars too here. So yeah, he's producing riflemen and jaguars, a nice counter to hammers, I must say. But you can see I'm using vehicle scouting boost to as I said, speed is more important on this map than brute force. Okay, moving my hammers over to this direction, making them think that I will attack from here, then moving back to attack from here. You see, there it is. His riflemen were going towards this side, then they saw my hammer approach come from this side. So yeah, speed overcomes brute force. Yeah, meanwhile I'm still producing hammers non-stop, rallying them over to this point. Okay, kill it, nice. Okay, now I'll cause as much damage as possible. I will kill that supply center as well. He has porcupine, jaguars, lot of jaguars. Those are lot of jaguars. Okay, kill that power plant too. But okay, those are very lot of units. So he seems to be a very good player. Okay, a gun tower is here as well. Okay, nice. Okay, meanwhile I move this detachment of mine here so that I can use it in future for future engagement. Meanwhile I use the newly produced hammer of mine to attack him from this side, as I know that most of his units are over here. Taking advantage of this, I will be attacking him from this side. But as you can see, he's making gun towers as well, and well as riflemen are also fast, so they were able to come here in rather quick time. So yeah, I'll be killing that one gun tower that is under construction. Nice, killing those jaguars too, as they are all not on siege mode. See, jaguars that are not on siege mode are not much different from hammers. They have almost same HP and armor as hammers, and if they are not in siege mode, their firepower gets reduced by half, you see. So that's why many call hammers as moving jaguars. Okay, so he has a lot of riflemen over here, so yeah, smart thing to do. Producing, I think again, better riflemen are better against hammers than grenadier. Meanwhile, the old detachment that I had positioned over here, I moved it over to here. I'm attacking him from, engaging him from two sides, one from here and another from here. He has a gun tower. Okay, that's a max gun tower with gold defense boost. Gun towers don't have this much range at rank 16. Meanwhile, non-stop unit, I see that he's spamming riflemen. So keeping that in mind, I upgraded my barracks to level 3 so that I can produce flame assaults. You see, his rifleman strategy is proving to be very annoying for my hammers. I'm losing more hammers than the damage I am doing. So he too is relying mostly on speed of riflemen rather than brute force of jaguars. So he too was playing smart, but you see, Confederation has a straight counter to every resistance strategy. If he's producing riflemen, I'll produce flame assaults and they will do the job by mere double tap. That's all it will take. Okay, so upgrading, producing flame assaults now from 3 barracks and hammers too from... Okay, he has some riflemen over here. So I don't have enough flame assaults to engage them, so I'll be using hammers only. So you see these riflemen are doing some very good damage onto my hammers. So yeah, seeing this, I use switch to vehicle scouting boost. As against infantry, it is always recommended, as I said in earlier video, it is always recommended to use scouting boost instead of attack boost against infantry. So yeah, my flame stones aren't upgraded enough, they are only half upgraded or maybe less than half, but even a less upgraded or zero upgraded flame assaults will do a significant damage onto the riflemen. Flame assaults are very strong anti-infantry, as you all can see. Some handful of flame assault killed those riflemen. So yeah. Also, flame assault take only one command point, so that's a positive. So he's going for gun towers. Gun towers are spread across his entire base, so it will be hard for me to engage him, to attack him. So are they producing hammers, only hammers as well as flame assault? Flame assaults against infantry and hammers against buildings and jaguars. Okay, producing units non-stop. Okay, sent in one flame assault to keep a watch. Okay, he has some lot of riflemen over here. Saying this, I would be directing my flame assault to engage these riflemen. He's producing a lot of riflemen. Okay, there goes my flame assault, roasting every resistance unit they can find. Everything is getting roasted at here. Okay, meanwhile, not strong flame assault production, as well as hammer production. These riflemen with which he attacked me are getting roasted. Also, he's still managing to kill many of my flame assaults because they aren't well upgraded, but his riflemen are maxed out. Okay, I'll be upgrading, attacking now with hammers as well as flame assaults. You see, I have a lot of hammers now. My hammer strength lies in their number, so really earlier engagement, I got caught up at this point, so this turned out to be a choke point for me, so he took advantage. So now I'll be rallying my units over to this point. Also producing newly producing units will also be moving over to this point. Okay, I'll be attacking him now using vehicle scouting boost to increase the speed of my... Okay, he has Jaguar positioned over here in a nice concave. So let's see what I'll do. Okay, he has... So this engagement would not be right for me. You see, his Jaguars are in very good formation. I will be moving my hammers and putting my flame assaults on kite mode. You see, on patrol mode while I'm kiting my hammers. So it's double micro, it's hard, but it is a very lethal way. He has positioned his Jaguars on to this point. I will use the mobility of my hammers and attack him from the sides, or better, attack him through the back. Okay, he's moving his Jaguars now. So Jaguars when they're moving are not much of a threat, as I already told you. Okay, his riflemen are getting roasted thanks to those flame assaults, but those flame assaults are also getting killed because they are less upgraded. Also, they are under continuous Jaguar fire. Okay, he's seeing his hammers are not in siege mode, I decided to attack. So but he managed to since I am engaging Jaguars, mostly Jaguars now, instead of vehicle scouting boost, I switch to vehicle attack boost. So let's see how it goes, how powerful these hammers are. These hammers are mostly firing at flame assaults. Also flame assaults, since they get really close, like really close to those hammers, they also cause these Jaguars to die of their own splash damage. Okay, meanwhile, newly produced units are also getting, will also be moving here. Okay, I will kill, okay, look at the range of that gun tower. Gun tower doesn't have this much range at rank 16, so he's on the gold defense boost. So it's fine, I'm also on defense boost. I'm also on attack boost, okay. Kill that gun tower. Okay, kill that special vehicle factory. Meanwhile, my flame assaults are there, killing near the barrack, killing every rifleman that will get out of it. So yeah, meanwhile, I'm destroying his building. So yeah, at this moment, he has already raised the white flag and he will soon be blowing off his building. So yeah, that's it. If you like the battle, please like the video and subscribe to my channel. Also press the bell icon so that you will get notification every time I upload a video. So with that said, thank you and have a nice day. Okay, destroying his base. Yeah, destroyed everything, destroyed that gun tower. Flame assaults, hammer. Okay, what I think what he should have done was he should have gone for dragonflies. They would have been a better counter to hammers and flame assaults than jaguars and riflemen. You see, flame assaults are absolutely defenseless against dragonfly, and so are hammers. So yeah, that's it. GG, thank you, and have a nice day.